Hi, everybody. I'm Rob Jolliffe, and this is another Ask the Experts from Sabre Limited. Okay, let's get into this. So today we're going to talk about Business Central versus Finance and Supply Chain. This is a long topic with a lot of content in it. I'm going to try and go through it fairly quickly. It's a repeat of something I've done in the past. So I'm Rob Jolliffe, and I'm a Microsoft Dynamics Business Central expert. I'm not an expert in finance and supply chain, but a couple of months ago, I attended a kind of a, hold them up to the light differences webinar that, or actually in-person seminar that Microsoft sponsored. And I just kind of want to walk through a little bit of that for you today. I'm going to make some assumptions. If you're watching this, you're probably a small, medium enterprise business. You're looking for sort of a mid-market ERP system for your small business, and you're coming down on Dynamics 365, but you're trying to decide between these two products. One thing to comment on before I jump right into it is down in the description below, there's a link to my calendar and you can book a meeting with me, 30-minute meeting. It's free, no obligation. And just ask me any questions you have. I have I enjoy getting feedback. I enjoy hearing from people and hearing what you liked or didn't like about the videos I did, or asking me any questions. So please don't hesitate. It doesn't bother me at all. I really, really like, hearing from you. So we're going to talk about Microsoft Dynamics 365, and they have products Business Central and Finance and Supply Chain. So there are two ERP systems in Dynamics 365. And think of Dynamics 365 as a brand, not as a product. And it confuses people because sometimes they're used interchangeably. So the Finance and Supply Chain product has been known as AX, Dynamics 365 Enterprise, Dynamics 365 Finance and Operations. The Business Central product has been known mostly as Dynamics NAV, although occasionally as Navision. So at one time in the past, Microsoft had a division, a brand group called Dynamics, and there were four ERP systems in Dynamics. There was Great Plains, Navision, Solomon, and Xapta. And they rebranded them after they purchased them around 2000. They rebranded them as GP, NAV, SL, and AX. When they moved to Dynamics 365, they started moving things into the cloud, which they did, of course, they did Office and Outlook first and then gradually other things. they decided GP was not a fit for the cloud. But they did find that the NAV product worked well in the cloud, and they moved it over and they called it Business Central. It's the same product. It's just rebranded. Same thing with the SL product. It didn't work. It was not compatible with cloud technology, but the Xapta product was. And so that became what we're going to talk about today, finance and supply chain. So we started as on-prem, back in the 2000s. So Microsoft acquired these in 1999 and 2000 or 2001. And so we're talking about stuff from the 2000s that has now been migrated into the cloud. Finance and supply chain first, about 10 years ago, and Business Central second, around 6 years ago. So to understand the features of these two products, Microsoft has this incredibly long and difficult to read guide. I have this URL. I'm going to put it in the description down below if you want to download it. But what I'm trying to do is I'm just trying to give you kind of like a summary of it in this video. So we're going to talk about finance and structural differences in between Business Central and finance and supply chain. Then we're going to jump into manufacturing and supply chain and projects. So the first thing to note is that Business Central is designed to be run in a region. If you're going to run a second Business Central environment in a different region, you're running two Business Central environments. It's not one connected one that's in two regions. It's just two different ones. Whereas finance and supply chain is meant to be run multi-regionally from one centralized system. So the same login to the same finance and supply chain from the United States or from Brazil or from Australia is connected to the UK-based headquarters, but the data is stored locally to the people who are using local data. And then there's a centralized data repository up in the middle that's kind of distributed down. So that's a big difference between the design. And the practical implication of that is that because I'm going to have centralized master tables for the whole company to use, and I'm going to have regional local tables for the local regional areas to use, I have way more tables in finance and supply chain. The other thing to note is if I took Business Central, I added a whole bunch of add-ons to it, that might become 4,000 tables because all the add-ons have tables. Finance and supply chain has more out-of-the-box features. So that's why part of the reason why you get this much, much larger table structure. Just a simple example. If I want to sell an item in Business Central, I set it up in one table called Items. I have some related tables I might have to put data in. If I want to sell the same product in Finance and Supply Chain, I have to set it up as a master product with its information. Then I have to release that product. And then I have to set it up in the local company as an inventory item. So I actually have to set up three tables to sell one item, or three sets of data to sell one item in Finance and Supply Chain, one set of data in Business Central to do the same thing. So Finance and Supply Chain is purpose-built to be used by more than one company at the same time with one central repository of things like products and customers and vendors. So it is not designed to be used by one company with one location, with one, you know, general ledger, with one chart of accounts, one business, like one set of items, one set of, it's just not designed for that. It's designed for many companies that have to share all that information out and diversify it. So as I said, Business Central is designed for one company to use with one master record of customers and vendors, et cetera, et cetera. And then you could set up more companies, but each company exists as an independent entity and isn't sharing like a master chart of accounts or a master customer list or master vendor list or item list. You copy them back and forth, and there's some add-ons that help create synchronization between them. But inherently, Business Central is intended to be SMB multi-entity if you want that, so that you've got a whole bunch of different companies that do different things and you roll up to some central location. Okay. The user interfaces between the two are very simple versus very complex. So if I look at the user interface of Business Central, it's easy to use. If I want to look up information about warehousing, I just type into the search warehouse. I could find the warehouse menu as well, but there's only like 30 items in the warehouse menu. If I use Finance and Supply Chain, it's got a much bigger menu, but some of the menus like this replenishment and cycle counting and outbound and inbound, they're collapsed. It's bigger than this. So Finance and Supply Chain has just a lot more stuff in it. And I'll talk about this later, but that means there's a lot more to set up. You can't use it and skip setting up 90% of it. You have to set it up, even if you're setting it up to not use it. So the big difference is from a financial point of view, is between GAAP and IFRS. And I had to look up IFRS because I just don't have very many companies that fall into this category. But IFRS are the financial standards for publicly traded companies. And that's the default configuration of Finance and Supply Chain. So it's default designed for all that Sarbanes-Oxley stuff that you need when you're a publicly traded company, separation of duties and security and all of that stuff. Ideally, great. But if you're a company with like a controller and two assistants who are working with you, you do not have time to set this up and maintain it. It's designed for much larger companies with a lot more staff who can, you know, have a dedicated person to maintain certain parts of it that you just wouldn't normally have in the small business. Okay, supply chain differences. So I've kind of documented out the what I think are the most important areas of Finance and Supply Chain and Business Central. And I've noted that the white ones, the white pieces of information, those are out of the box. And the yellow ones need some sort of add-on and are external. And you'll notice Business Central is half add-ons. It's half add-ons if you need those add-ons. And I think this is the distinction. If you're a company and your sophistication level is you need cross-docking and container packaging and license plates and native zones and areas and mobile device support in your ERP system, and you're that sophisticated that you need all of that stuff, you should probably look at Finance and Supply Chain and Business Central. Especially if you're like a million square foot warehouse and you're planning on putting like automated robots in it or something, you should be looking at Finance and Supply Chain. If you have very simple warehousing requirements, you may not even want mobile devices walking around on the warehouse floor scanning stuff, and you need much more basic requirements, they're all there in Business Central. Business Central handles warehousing quite well in companies that have like a 200,000 square foot warehouse and they don't need all of that stuff. It's fine. Mobile device can be added to it really inexpensively compared to upgrading the Finance and Supply Chain. These add-ons are really, really good quality. You're just going to be better off getting Business Central if you don't need all of that stuff. So that would be the big kind of difference in my mind between the two from that point of view. So manufacturing differences. So once again, if we look at the two lists, we got the Business Central and a lot of it's yellow. A lot of these things are just not available out of the box. The most important one is the second one on both. The discrete manufacturing capabilities of both systems are pretty similar in their core capabilities. Finance supply chain adds a bunch of extra stuff for engineering, change controls and managements and stuff. But Business Central and Finance Supply Chain, discrete manufacturing out of the box, pretty good. Batch or process manufacturing is not available in Business Central out of the box. There are really good add-ons. Sabre doesn't know anything about those add-ons. We actually would recommend another company if you were in that area, and I know a few, and I can tell you who they are. But that batch manufacturing process in Business Central needs that add-on. In Finance and Supply Chain, it's native. You get to the graphical scheduler, finite capacity planning, approvals and engineering change management, MESs and integrations, those sorts of things. Again, it's like I said with supply chain. Do you need them? If you need them, if you need all of this stuff, if you're like, I'm very sophisticated, I need these capabilities, I can't wait till later, they're not phase two, then you need to look at finance and supply chain. Otherwise, you should really be looking at Business Central. And finally, we're going to talk about projects. The big difference, in my opinion, between the projects, between the two systems is the Business Central project. If you're doing a project, takes a year to do, $1 million sale, maybe $2 million or a couple hundred thousand bucks. And that project, what you need is you need the basics of project accounting, project management. It's good. It's going to be a good system. It's going to be way better than most ERP systems that are sold to businesses like that. A million times better than QuickBooks. If you are doing a multi-year, multi-jurisdictional, $2 billion project, you're building a hydroelectric dam someplace, and you've got 50,000 hours of engineering time that needs to go into it, and you need that project management capability to control all of this, your finance and projects is going to be much better. Notice I say finance and projects, not supply chain, because the project manufacturing module of finance is a separate module. It's completely different. With Business Central, it comes out of the box, and it's a core module of Business Central. With finance and supply chain, it's not. You have to add it. The last note I'm going to make is that Business Central add-ons, such as they are very easy to install. They're like one-click install, just like on your phone. The finance and supply chain, not just the add-ons, but the actual configuration of the out-of-the-box systems, nothing is like a wizard-driven. Okay, so I'm going to leave you with some final thoughts. And there's a few. There's one that I haven't written down, but I think I'm going to add. So between Business Central and Finance Supply Chain really comes down to cost and sophistication. If you are sophisticated enough that a 5x extra cost to implement and maintain and support the product, as well as a 2x or higher extra cost for the actual software licenses for the base products makes sense, and then look at finance and supply chain. And you're going to be, to really be in that space, you need to be a very large corporation, in my opinion. You do not want to be a, let's say, under 250 employee SMB manufacturing company with two locations. Don't look at finance and supply chain. If you are in that smaller space, it absolutely makes sense to look at Business Central. And if you're in that much larger space, it absolutely makes sense to look at finance and supply chain. There is an occasional middle where you need to look at both. And here's where I would say one of the defining factors is. If you're going to build an internal process improvement team controlled within the IT department's mandate, where it's going to have business analysts, project managers, process improvement team members who are ERP consultants, like internal ERP consultants who work for you, and you're going to have a group of them. So let's say you're going to have five or six. So you're going to have a developer or two, let's say two developers, three, four business analysts, a project manager, maybe a supervisor of that team. That's finance and supply chain. That's finance and supply chain is written all over you. Okay. If you got an IT manager, maybe you have one person who does Power BI reports, or you outsource all your IT to a managed service provider and you don't have internal IT, but you have a couple power users, Business Central is the right way to go. Because Business Central is designed for that low overhead IT, and finance and supply chain is designed for like heavy IT requirements. Okay. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it adds value to you and helps you make your decision. Yeah, we release new videos every week. I try and release a video maybe once a month or every couple months, or sometimes I'll do them in spurts. But Please just subscribe to our channel, ring that bell icon so you're notified of any new videos that come out. And if you want to contact us outside of social media in the real world, and maybe on social media, like, this is our website. An email address, this does come to me, and my personal LinkedIn. Please feel free to connect to me on LinkedIn, and you can send me questions there as well. I thank you so much for watching this video all the way to the end, and have a great day.